My name is Federico Tartarini, and in this video I'm going to explain how to use the EN16798 tab of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool. This one, along with the ASHRAE 55 tab, are the main tabs of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool. They are the main tabs because they allow you to calculate the PMV model in accordance with the two main international standards. One is the ASHRAE 55, which is currently in its 2020 version, and the other main international standard is the EN16798, which is a European standard. The calculation of the PMV in the EN16798 standard is based on the model that is presented in the ISO 7730. So you can use our tool to calculate the PMV in accordance with this standard. As for the other tabs of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool, on the left side here we have the inputs, and on the right side we have the outputs. The output values are updated automatically as you change the inputs, and also the figures and the visualizations are updated automatically. Let me show you how it works. The first thing that we need to select is whether we want to use the PMV method or the adaptive method. I'm not going to explain how to use adaptive method in this video, and I'm going to explain it in another video. So check out my channel if you want to find out more about the adaptive method. Then we need to provide the 6 input parameters required to calculate the PMV. Sometimes these parameters can be 5 if you decide to toggle this switch here, which is use operative temperature, which basically we're going to input instead of the air temperature and the mean radiant temperature, the operative temperature. If at any point you don't know or you're not familiar with any of these variables here, just click here on the variable name and you will be redirected to Wikipedia or to our website, in which we explain in detail what each variable means. I would also encourage you to read the ISO 7730, which explains how to measure this variable. For instance, both the air temperature, mean radiant temperature, and air speed are generally the average value measured at 3 different heights, and the heights are selected based on the posture of the occupants. If the person is sitting, the heights at which you have to measure these 3 parameters are 0.1, 0.7, and 1.1 meters. On the other hand, if the person is standing, then the heights at which you have to measure these parameters are 0.1, 1.1 meters, and 1.7 meters. So here we can change the values, and as you can see, as I change the value, then the results here are updated automatically. Please note that the airspeed that you are entering here is the measured airspeed. The tool automatically calculates the activity generated airspeed. So for metabolic higher than 1, then you will see that a new output here appears, which is the relative airspeed, which takes into account the self-generated airspeed by the person which is moving. So as the person is moving around or is moving his limbs, he's going to experience a slightly higher airspeed than the one that you have measured. Then you can input the relative humidity. And here, if you haven't measured the relative humidity, but you want to input the humidity ratio, dew point, wet bulb, or vapor pressure, you can also do so. Just click on one of these, and then you can actually enter the dew point temperature. Then there is the metabolic rate, which we have already changed. And if you're not familiar with typical metabolic rates, you can always use this drop down here, where you will find typical metabolic rates for a variety of activities, such as reading, writing, typing, standing, and so forth. So you can pick one here, which is closer to the type of activity that the participant in your space are actually doing. Finally, the last input, which is very important for you to understand, is the dynamic loading insulation. You can calculate this value as per ISO 7730 section C2. So basically, you shouldn't use the value of CLO that you calculate by summing all the clothing insulation of the different layers and different clothes, but you should calculate the dynamic clothing insulation as per section C2 of the ISO 7730. Please note that, as I've shown in the ASHRAE 55 video, then the dynamic clothing insulation and the measured clothing insulation will differ, and the difference will be higher as the metabolic rate increases. Why this is true? Because as the person is moving around and as it has a higher metabolic rate, this affects the contact between the clothing and the skin. So most likely, if the person is moving around, is going to pump air under his clothing, and this will affect the clothing insulation of the clothing that this person is wearing. As I showed you before, on the right we have the results. So for this set of condition here, we can see that the PMV is 0.49, the PPD, which is the predicted percentage of dissatisfied, is 10%, and in compliance with the EN 16798, we are also reporting the comfort category. So this standard defines three comfort category, category 1, 2, and 3, and then we are reporting this value. We are also showing the three comfort category here on the psychrometric chart. In the psychrometric chart, we have the dry bulb air temperature on the x-axis and the humidity ratio on the y-axis, which is a normal psychrometric chart. But in addition, we are showing the point which depicts the condition that you have entered into the tool. So for instance, if we want to make sure that the person is inside category 1, or the conditions are in within category 1, we have to decrease for the other environmental and personal parameters, we have to decrease the temperature to 25 degrees, and we are back into category 1. And we can see all the properties of moist air shown here next to the chart. So as I move my cursor around, I can see all the properties of air of the chart. So in this point here, for instance, we have a relative humidity of 29.5%. At the bottom, there is an explanation of what the chart is actually showing. As explained at the bottom of the chart, in these specific figures, since we are only showing the dry bulb air temperature at the bottom, we are assuming that the mean radiant temperature is constant throughout all these conditions. This is very unlikely in normal situations, so it is usually better to have a look at the psychrometric with the operative temperature on the x-axis. The operative temperature combines both the mean radiant temperature and the air temperature in one single value. So here, every point will have the same operative temperature. So you will not have such big gaps between the air temperature and the mean radiant temperature. Because if you go back here to the air temperature chart and we set the mean radiant temperature to, let's say, 26, then when the condition indoors will be 12 degrees as a dry bulb air temperature, we're also assuming a mean radiant temperature of 26, which is very unlikely. So if you look at the operative temperature chart, it's usually more representative of a normal space. When you use our tool, it's always a good practice of having a look at which version you are using. You're going to release new versions as time passes, or as people find bugs, or as we release new features. So it's a very nice practice to note down which version you are using. And if you're using our tool for a scientific publication or for a report, we would highly encourage you to cite us if you're using this software. You can click here at the bottom and on the reference, and you can read our paper, or alternatively, you can use this text to cite us. At the bottom here, we also put link to the open source code, so you can click and you will be redirected to GitHub. And then you're going to be able to visualize our code, all the things that we have done, You can suggest changes, you can contribute to the code base. All contributions are highly welcome. Then, if you spot an issue, you can also open an issue here, and there is a button, and you can also check our videos that we have released about the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool, and you can access them by clicking on this link. Finally, I just want to show you the last buttons here that we have on the tool, on the input section, so we can create a custom ensemble, so we can select clothes and different part of clothes that we can sum them all together to create a custom ensemble. So we can say socks, shoes, and then we can say a short, t-shirt, and then we can, once we are happy with this selection, we can also remove if you want something. So if you want to remove the socks, then you can click on set cloth value, and this is going to be the cloth value that is calculated for this ensemble. You can collapse this tab by clicking again on the button. You can click on reset to reset to the default condition. You can set the pressure, the atmospheric pressure. And if you're not familiar with SI unit, you can also use IP unit. And our tool is going to update automatically. So you're going to have the temperature in Fahrenheit and all the different units for the IP system. You also have the local discomfort tab, which I'm not going to cover today. And you can also calculate the meridian temperature from the globe temperature. So let me go back here to the air temperature. Let me click here. And let me switch back to SI unit here. So you can see the measured air temperature. You can see the measured air speed, the measured globe temperature. And then based on these input parameters, our tool will calculate the meridian temperature. And then you can click on set meridian temperature. And this value will be updated automatically here. And the figure again will be updated. If you still have questions about our tool, I would highly encourage you to read our documentation that we have uploaded online on our website, so you can browse our documentation. But if you still have questions or if you have comments, you can also send us an email. You can click here at the top on the help page, and then you can send us an email at cbecomforttool@gmail.com. Alternatively, if you have any questions, you can leave them also here in the comment section below. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for listening, and see you in the next video.